Hello and welcome to this full video tutorial and overview of me showing you how to use Descript. Descript is an editing tool where you can create podcasts, videos, and it'll eliminate hours off of your workflow. It's an AI-powered editing tool that lets you edit audio and video like a text document, and I'm about to walk you through a full beginner's guide and tutorial. So let's go ahead and dive in. Go over to Descript.com or use our link in the pinned comment or description to get started for free. And then when you're ready to go, you will open up a new page or a new project in Descript that looks like this. But before we go and start editing something, I'm going to go back to my homepage here, and I am going to go ahead and go to a project, a podcast that I was working on recently. So here's a podcast that I was working on recently, and I just want to give you an overview of what you're going to be working with once you're in Descript. So once you have the tool downloaded, and by the way, you can either download for Mac, PC, whatever computer or device that you have, or you can go over to Descript.com and it's web-based. You can use all of the tools and suite of features. Most of them, there's some that require the app, but most of them can be done remotely within your web browser. So as you can see here over on the left-hand side, I have the text. This is a text-based editor. And what is the benefit of doing this? Let's just say that I messed up right here where I say, and we talk with them about their journey. You can click and highlight like you're in a Word document or a formatting software, and you can basically hit the backspace and it deletes it. So you're basically editing per the words that you're saying. Now, the benefit of transcript or text-based editing is the nuances of getting really detailed of what you can cut out. Another cool thing is they have an AI tool called the Underlord. Go to the Underlord here and you make these tools available to you here, and you'll see an option that says remove filler words. Now, removing filler words for a podcast editor used to take hours on end combing through the audio. But now you can click on remove filler words, and if it discovers the filler words, like or it will highlight them, show you how many there are, and it will basically allow you to remove all of them by clicking on remove all, and it removes all of those filler words at once. And if you don't want to do all of them because you're worried about the flow of the show, you can actually scroll down through the text here. It'll highlight them, and you can select which ones you want to eliminate. Now, once you open up Descript, what are you going to see? You're going to see the projects panel over here on the left. That's where we want to get started. Click into projects like I've done here, and then go to new project. You can also record in Descript, and we'll talk about that later. Go ahead and click on new project, and you have the option to choose between a video or an audio project. We're going to choose video project. And then what we're going to do is we're going to go to upload file. So we can upload file here. We can import a Zoom call. We can write an AI speech to do it that way, or we can record. We're going to go to upload file by clicking on this option here. Go ahead and find the video or file you want to use and select it. As with anything, you can select multiple files if there are going to be multiple files you're working with, and click open or double click. And as you see, it will begin importing the file. You can see the activity down here in the lower right-hand corner. It will detect speakers, and then it will have a pop-up that says, hey, is this one or two speakers? Is there three people? And it will identify the different speakers and different people in the video, and it will differentiate between them with color in the text-based editor on the left-hand side. Now, with anything with the UI, you can click and hold and drag and make the video bigger. You can make the text area bigger. I like to do a 50-50 split, and it depending on the size of the file, it could take up to a few minutes depending on the footage quality plus the duration of the video. Once the transcription is done, you should see the information over here on the left-hand side. And any filler words like or will be underlined to let you know where they are. And you can highlight those words by just clicking and holding and highlighting them. And it gives you a couple of options. You can correct by hitting C or hit correct. And you can even change it. So you can change that text to be something different. You can go here and highlight it again. And you can regenerate. You can ignore it. You can bold it to add some emphasis. Or you can highlight it so you know where it is for later. But if you hit the backspace or delete key on your keyboard, it completely removes it. And you're going to see wherever you remove text, you're going to see a little bitty line. So you're going to see two kind of dotted or dashed lines. And now when I play it back, it'll just say Sandra, and then it won't have the filler word. As I mentioned earlier, you can go to remove filler words. You can see there's 326 of them. All of them will be highlighted. You can click on remove all, and it removes all of the filler words. Now, what else can you do other than just the simple editing of going through the text, watching it play back? You can bring up the timeline. So here at the bottom, you go to show timeline and it brings up a normal looking timeline of working. Now, up on the kind of upper area of the timeline, you can see the words that are being said as the waveform is going on. So if we play this back, like you see here, it will continue to play back and it'll show me the waveform as I'm going. I prefer going to the text-based editor, have the timeline showing in case I need to make a really delicate or really intricate cut of something very small. Now, as far as the timeline goes down here, there's a couple of things that you can do. You have the tool here, the blade tool. So selecting the blade tool allows you to trim or cut an area here where you can click and hold the timeline and pull it left or right, extending or eliminating some areas of the timeline like that I'm doing here. Then we have the tool here that is the range tool. This will allow you to select a specific range. So I can select a range here, move that around, do a different things like that. You can do Command or Control Z to undo, or you can go to Edit, Undo, or Redo up here in the Edit menu, and that will undo what you've just done. Next, we have the Slip tool. The Slip tool allows you to go here and move left or right audio to really get in the details of putting an area or section exactly where you want it. And then the Hand tool just allows you to navigate, click and hold, and drag through where you are on the timeline. Another thing that we can do is transitions. So if we go to transitions here, there are certain transitions that we can add wherever our cursor is over here on the text. So if we want a transition here, we highlight that. You'll see your cursor blinking. You go to transition, go to layout here, and then we can decide how we want our layout. Do we want it to be a single camera, a zoom, a screen, a multicam? We can go to screen here, and you can see it puts us down here in the screen. And if you're a podcaster or a video editor, this is wonderful because now we can go right here, go to the placeholder, and we can basically add an image to use right here in the background. So I'm going to undo that. But just so you know, you can add animations and transitions all by going to transition here, transition in or out. And then you have the different things. If we want to do in, we'll do a fade in. And then wherever the cursor is, when we play that back, it's going to add a transition. Now, the power in this tool, a lot of it is going to be done with the Underlord AI tool. I'm going to walk you down the different things that we can do with this tool and then let you decide which ones you want to play around with. Basically, Edit for Clarity will remove filler words, digressions, blabbering, and it lets AI do basically all of the obvious cuts. So if we go Edit for Clarity, we have an option to edit intensity, low, medium, or heavy. I normally go low or medium. And basically what this allows me to do, if I go to submit, it will begin to work and the AI will do its magic where it'll remove all filler words, all things that it think to be where the obvious cuts are. So if you're recording and you mess up and you're like, oh, retake, and there it is. And we can click on all of these cuts. So if we click on a cut here, it'll take us right here and says business to the next level. So it's just more content. And that's basically me repeating myself. Now, if I don't like that cut, I can hit the X. If I want to make the cut, I can go to accept edit, and that will accept that edit. Same thing goes here. It's adding a little bit of where it thinks I might be repeating myself. I found that I don't use the edit for clarity very much. What I normally do is I go to remove filler words and just start there, let them highlight all of the filler words, and then I can go and pick the ones that I want to remove. That's the Underlord tool, and that's the top, the kind of sound good option here. Removing retakes. This one here, I don't use as much, but if there is an obvious retake of where you're pausing and you're like, okay, let's start again, it can detect that. But again, you can use the AI tool to highlight it and show you over here on the text, but I recommend that you do the cuts yourself. So that's remove retakes. Shorten word gaps. If there are large word gaps or pauses like this one here, which obviously is my outro where I have the music playing, that's going to be where there's some pauses there. It's letting you know where there are elongated silences to where you may want to cut. Again, I use the tool to identify them, go over to the text, and then highlight them and correct or remove them myself. That's everything that's under the Sound Good panel other than the add chapters. If you want to add chapters for a video so you know to go back on when you're tagging them when you upload to YouTube, you can go to add chapters and you can basically auto number them and then go to auto and submit, and it will add chapters for you, right? In the script where you can go say, hey, this is the introduction. Here's where I want that marker. And then you can timestamp things that way. So that's everything under the first section there. Next is going to be eye contact. Now, this selects the entire video or track. And it basically, if you turn this on, if your eyes are not looking at the camera, it does a pretty good job that if we go here and we look at the audio here where I am, so if I go to this little area here, it does a fairly good job. I'm looking at the camera here in the actual video, but if I wasn't, it will make my eyes look as if they are looking into the lens, into the camera. Again, play around with that. With any AI tool, I recommend you make sure you do a little bit of the fine tuning, but you let the AI kind of start the process for you. So that's what the AI does there within the eye contact. Center active speaker, if you're off center, kind of speaker right in the middle of the screen. So if we go to center active speaker, we want this to be landscape. We go to submit, and then we turn that on. It will basically run that. You can see the activities running here. And if I'm off center, like you see me here a little bit to the right, if you're looking at it from the person speaking, it will use the AI to put them in what it believes to be center framing. So depending on your use case, maybe that's something that you want. Next is green screen. If you're using a green screen, you can click on the green screen option here. It'll remove the background with AI, and you can replace it with something better or something that looks better if you want. Generate an image. This is just a normal AI image generator where you can create images to utilize in your video if that's something you want to do. And then repurpose. Now we're getting to the real power of the creating from what you have here in Descript. So if we go to repurpose, we can go to create clips, and then we can choose a layout. Now here's going to be a layout. Let's do this layout here. We want to create three. We'll create, let's say, three clips. So we'll go to three here like this. And we want them to be, let's say, 60 seconds, right? That's the duration. And then you can always go to see more layouts, and you can see the different layouts here. But we want them to be vertical. And we want to go ahead and you can even type in a topic to grab from the longer video and go to submit. This will use Underlord and the AI tool to basically grab clips or what it thinks to be highlights of the video to create short form vertical videos for you. So as you can see, here's one here that it created. And if I go here, I can press play here exactly where I want it. And it creates that right here with the captions from it. So I can click on them here. It'll create another one here, another vertical video, as you see here. So if I click that and play, it'll create that. We can accept them. We can change the layout. We can hit the X to remove them. As you can see, here I am right here with the caption. I can click that, move the caption around. It's got the little grid lines that I can play around with. I can change the color of the text. Again, Descript is great for curating everything in one place. So once you do the edits, you can then create shorts from that. You can then create other clippings from that and repurpose, all done from the Underlord tool, just like you're about to see here. So that's Create Clips. Under Create Highlight Reel, it'll create a supercut, like a composition, basically like the best moments of the show. If you want to put out like a promo video, it tries to do that there. More things for podcasting there. Find highlights. Did something get said that was interesting, or find something that's compelling? It'll find that. Translate. So it'll translate your transcript, captions, and audio to other languages. If you click on that, go to dub speech, turn that on. You want to translate that to, let's say I'm going to translate that to Korean or Japanese. I can do so by selecting that there. And remember, this is a part of the premium plan. If you want more dubbing, this is a service that you'd have to go out of Descript for unless you want to pay the tool to do it for you. Next is publish right here. Draft a title, summarize. I use these quite frequently to get ideas. So I can click on draft a title, hit submit, and it will give me a list of what it believes to be good titles for this video. Overcoming Challenges, Sandra D's Journey to Full-Time Content Creation. And it gives me 10 of them, and I can go and either follow up and respond and say, hey, I want them to be shorter. I want them to be more about this, and they can do that. Or I can click done, copy them, and paste them into wherever I'm curating everything for my video. Drafting a title, very good. Summarize, that'll basically summarize, give you a brief description of that. Show notes are for podcasting. It'll summarize the podcast. Go to draft show notes, hit submit, and it'll take a few minutes to a few seconds, depending on the length of the video or show, and give you a full show notes where you get a breakdown of all of the timestamps as well as a good description. Speaking of description, there's one here that says draft a YouTube description, and this will be more shorter for videos. I can click on draft a YouTube description, and it'll automatically create a YouTube description for me, and you can create a social post and a blog post from AI as well. Again, I'm going to say, with these tools, I've used all of them. Again, you're going to have to tweak them yourself, but it gives you a great starting point. Under Write, it allows you to refine your script and rewrite things. I haven't used these as much, but you can write an outline, especially if you haven't already recorded anything and you're in a blank document. So that's really everything that Underlord does. It's a humongous tool that they continue to add to even to this day. Next, we have the project option here where we can see all the compositions, all of our files. If we want to add more files, you go to project here, click the addition symbol, and you can upload from your computer. You can create a sequence, add a new folder to organize your files, or import from Zoom. We'll just upload from our computer and we will select that audio file. And now when we do that, we're going to see that audio file here. We can either insert it into a script or hit X to leave it over here in our media bin. It'll transcribe any audio or video that you bring into it. Just know that from the beginning. Another thing I wanted to show you is if you want to make the video or audio sound better, you can go over here to Studio Sound under Sound Good, click on Studio Sound, and it will apply what it believes to be a filter that makes the sound better or higher quality. I normally go down here to Studio Sound, hit the little settings icon here and go to intensity, and I drag that down to about 40. I start at 40. I see how much it's improved my audio. I have a pretty good setup here in my studio, but if you don't, it will allow you to, you know, remove that background hiss or background noise, the white noise that you're getting sometimes. And it will also amplify the good sound and good noise to make your voice sound better as well. So start at 40, play it back, see if it's working, and then go from there. Now, what if you want to record? So we're going to go back to our home here, and we're going to go right next to new project where it says record. If you click on record, it says record with others or record camera, mic, or screen. If you go to record camera, mic, or screen, it will bring up these options for you. As you can see, there is my camera, which is my Logitech. Then I have right here, I can also choose my camera for my iPhone. So I can go here and I can, this is my iPhone camera, and I can record with my iPhone camera and it can show you what I'm doing here. So if I wanted to, I could just move my iPhone camera anywhere I wanted it and use it as a camera. So that's how you do that there. The default microphone is whatever my main microphone is here, and I can choose those by the drop-down menu. And then basically what I would do is I would hit record or go ahead and go to record into script, hit record, it'll count us down. And then we basically go here and we start recording. So as you can see, I'm recording. You can see it counting down there, and then go ahead and hit stop. And then once I do that, it will bring that recording over here. And as you can see, here's whatever we just recorded. I can move that around on the timeline. I can delete it if I want to and start over. If you want to record with other people, what you would have to do is go back home here, go to record with others, and then you would basically say, I want it to be smooth and easy. And then it will open up a new page here in your browser of choice. Make sure you are allowing the microphone in that, so hit allow whenever it's asking you to allow. Just make sure you hit allow like that I've done here. It'll open up the browser tab here. You give it a name, you share the link with those people, and basically type in your name. So I'm typing in my name, request to join, and you can then send them that link like you're seeing me here sit in my office, and this can be a great kind of studio for you to record in for your podcast. So the last thing we're going to be talking about today is exporting. So exporting your files, very important. If we go up to the export button, it's in the upper right-hand corner. Click on the export button. You have a number of options. You can export in video, audio, GIF, timeline, transcript, or subtitles. I'm going to show you the three that you're probably going to want. First is video. Select video, give it a name, and then the destination where you want it. So we want this to be a local export on our computer or PC or Mac. And then we go to export options. You can export in the current composition file format, or you can go here and under resolution, you can choose 4K all the way down to 480p. Quality, I normally set this to high. And then under audio, I can select this here and change the different sample rate and audio bit rate if needed. And then metadata and advanced, we're not going to go over. When you're ready, you go ahead and click export, and that'll export that video file to your computer. Same goes for audio. You go to audio here. We want it to be a local export. Choose the file format, which for me is normally MP3s for podcasting and WAV files for voiceovers. And then when I'm done, I hit export and it'll export that file. What you may want is you may want a subtitle file. Now, what does a subtitle file look like? You can see there's a file here that is a .srt. That file is a subtitle file. That is the file that you can upload directly to YouTube as you're uploading your video to make sure that your subtitles and captions are perfectly aligned as the video is playing back, or a podcast, whatever it may be. And that's it. That's how you edit podcasts and videos fast with Descript, utilizing their AI tools and suite of tools. Hopefully you found this helpful. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel for more great tutorials. And if you want to check out Descript, you can do so for free with the link below. See you guys in the next video.